In Qatar, U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken says the U.S. is working to continue evacuations from Afghanistan.
We're holding the Taliban to the commitments that they've made to ensure the free passage and safe travel for anyone who wants to leave Afghanistan, starting with any American citizens who wish to do so.
Well, Secretary Blinken also included any Afghans who are at risk under Taliban rule. Next week, the Secretary of State will have 2 days of testimony on Capitol Hill about Afghanistan. And joining us now is Amber Athey, Washington editor at The Spectator. Amber, welcome back. Great to see you. As we just heard, Secretary of State Antony Blinken said the U.S. is holding the Taliban to its commitments to ensure free passage and safe travel to anyone who wants to leave Afghanistan. This, though, as we're hearing reports of 6 chartered airplanes with evacuees not allowed to leave the Mazar Sharif airport. Your thoughts?
Well, it's really unfortunate that the Biden administration thinks that the Taliban can be held to its word when they already broke so many parts of the agreements that they've made with the Taliban, particularly in the beginning stages of the withdrawal. They were not allowing certain Americans to access the airport. There were reports that they were actually harming Americans. Now, unfortunately, looking at what's probably going to be similar to a hostage situation, because the U.S. has given up any leverage that it would have had if it still had a military presence in Afghanistan. So the Taliban really has no reason at this point to uphold its agreements, because the Biden administration has already made quite clear that they don't want to restart a war in Afghanistan. They're not going to send troops back in to try to fight the Taliban if they prevent Americans from having safe passage. The only thing that remains are diplomatic channels, which, when you're dealing with a terroristic organization, are pretty much doomed to fail.
Yeah, Amber, another story I want to talk about that a lot of people are talking about right now is the rescue of a woman and her children from Afghanistan. Apparently, the organizers of that rescue mission say the State Department is trying to claim credit, or at least partial credit, for that rescue, even though they say the State Department wasn't directly involved. What more do you know about that?
Right. We're still learning more about that particular situation, but it does fall in line with what other private rescue missions are saying, which is that they are going in using their own resources and their own talents to try to extricate Americans from the situation. And this is a great reminder of why Joe Biden's pullout policy was so ridiculous, because he did not prioritize getting Americans out of the country. Instead, we were filling up airplanes with hundreds of thousands of refugees and people who had not even been confirmed to have helped the U.S. military effort out of Afghanistan. Now we're left in a place where people are having to actually risk their lives and take in private funding to try to save Americans, because Americans can't even rely on their own government anymore.
Yeah, and sticking, you know, with Afghanistan, I'm sure you know today the Taliban named acting leaders in its interim government, and many do have connections to terrorist organizations. What do you expect to see from the country the Taliban is now calling the Islamic Emirate?
Well, it wouldn't be surprising to anyone to see huge human rights abuses. People have been warning about this for the past 10 months or so, even when President Trump was in office. People were warning about negotiations between the Afghan government and the Taliban because they did not believe they could be trusted. The Taliban has tried to say that they are a more progressive-minded organization now. That has been belied by their actions, where they are, again, preventing certain people from leaving Afghanistan, beating people who want to leave, and hunting down and putting bounties on people who assisted the U.S. military effort. So, unfortunately, I think we're going to see more of the brutality and abuse of individuals that we've come to expect from this very terroristic and destructive organization.
Well, Amber, thank you very much. Always appreciate your analysis. Amber Athey, Washington editor at The Spectator. Thank you again.
Thank you.